give you a subject, and we will let the Spirit do what it does. Amen?
Amen.
Genesis chapter number 21. Join me in verse number 18. The Bible says, "Arise, lift up the lad, and I hold him in thy hand, for I will make him a great nation." And God opened up her eyes, and she saw well the water, and she went and filled the bottle of water and gave the lad drink. And God was with the lad, and he grew and dwelt in the wilderness. This young boy 3 years old, Isaac is being treated better. It's all about him. Mm-hmm. And they forgot about the teenage boy. Mm-hmm. You know, if we're not careful, we can do that. We can have a younger baby and then we forget about our other kids.
That's right.
Oh, just okay. Verse 10. Wherefore she said to Abraham, cast out the bondwoman and her son. For the son of this bondwoman shall not be heir with my son. In other words, Sarah made it clear that he ain't going to get the same check as Isaac. Verse 11. And this thing was very grievous in Abraham's sight because of his son. Mm-hmm. And here's where we pick up in verse number 12. God said unto Abraham, let it not be grievous in thy sight because of the land and because of thy bondwoman in all that Sarah has said unto thee. Hearken unto her voice. For in Isaac shall thy seed be called. Now I want you to know something. Abraham is the man of the house. Mm-hmm. But yet, God is sharing with Abraham. Abraham, I want you to listen to the voice of your wife. Mm-hmm. Oh, Lord, I got to go right there for my wife. Because I want my wife and I want my husband to understand that God blessed you with the help me. And just because you're the head of the house does not mean you can't listen to your wife.
That's right.
And a lot of times our problems begin when it is that we don't want to console or run some things by our wives.
That's right.
Our wives are there for we women are very strong.
Yes.
In fact, sometimes they have more common sense than us as men.
Amen.
And the thing of that is, God gave them for us to for our help me. But watch this here. We as men have to give them something to help.
Amen.
What are you doing? See, the thing about it is, if I'm not doing anything, she has nothing to help.
That's right.
If I'm just showing up at church, she has nothing to help. Mm-hmm. Watch this here. I go, watch this here. So the Bible says, verse 13, and also the son of the bondwoman will I make a nation because he is thy seed. Now watch this here. Now we're talking about Ishmael. Satan has already given the mandate. Take your little big head boy and that girl, she ain't got to go. Mm-hmm. Get up out of this house. Now, if Abraham had any sense, he did the right thing and listened to God and listened to his wife. Mm-hmm. Or he would have bought his head. Happy life, happy wife,
happy home.
Y'all ain't waiting for this, so I'm going to go. Watch this. The Bible says, are y'all all right this
year? Yeah.
Y'all
yeah.
Got the corona or something? Because y'all are just, it's mine, it's harvest time. So what about the word?
Amen.
Amen.
Okay, maybe I can't preach. I don't know. Come on, I just, the Bible says, and this thing was very grievous. Skip down to verse number 13. And also the son of the bondwoman, I will make a nation because he is thy seed. Now watch this here. He said, even though Abraham, you messed up big time. You got about ahead of me. And whenever we get ahead of God,
come on.
Expect Ishmael to come out.
That's right.
A lot of us can't be happy. A lot of us are sad in these seats because we got ahead of God and we got Ishmael in our life.
That's right.
And not just kids. Ishmael is representing anything you do to get ahead of God. It's an Ishmael in your life.
That's right.
So what ends up happening is, but God said, even though you messed up, man, I'll still bring something good out of you.
Yes.
Because you got a covenant with me.
Amen. Amen. Yes.
Just because you got a covenant with me, even though you messed up, I sent Jesus because Jesus now covers your sin. I don't see your sin no more. And now I can still make something great out of you, even though you messed up, man.
Yes.
That's how I knew. Ishmael, I'm going to gonna make a great nation out of him.
Yep.
But hold on, God. I thought you was gonna make a great nation. I thought you was gonna make a great nation out of Isaac because he's a child of God.
Yeah.
Watch this here. Mm-hmm. He says, I am. Mm-hmm. That's who I'm gonna use.
Mm-hmm.
But I didn't allow babies to come in this world for no reason.
That's right.
I'm still gonna give him a purpose too.
Yes.
Everybody has a purpose.
Amen.
So I was here. Sometimes they in Muslims have more respect for who they believe. They believe in Allah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
But they have more respect for a worship setting.
Come on.
Look here. Yeah. Them guys, I don't care what they 3 times a day, they're gonna take their little carpet and they're gonna spread it out and they're gonna pray to God because that's what they believe in.
Amen. Amen.
Everybody, I just hear they do, even us as Christians, because we can't even come to church and worship with a smile on our face, and we serve the living God.
Amen.
So how can we talk about the Muslims?
That's right.
How can we talk about the Baptists? How can we talk about the Methodists and they respect their preacher or their pastor? They can never go against. In fact, you go against their preacher, they might knock your head off.
That's right.
See, the pastor won't even have to say that. All he had to do was preach the best. The pastor knocked you out, man. That's the kind of dedication that man that God is looking for.
Amen.
Because you're messing with the man of God.
Amen.
He has the blessing for my life in his mouth.
Yes.
If I don't believe that, I'll sit in the seat and look sour.
No.
Yeah.
So then, guess what? I don't worship Isaac. I don't worship Isaac's God. I worship Booth. If you look sad on the worship, you worship. Maybe you worship Buddha. Maybe you worship Allah. Maybe you worship Ishmael's God. Because the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob said, man, look here. I have a joy deep down in my heart. When God murders me and preaches, I can't sit still. I can't sit in the seat of the
faith.
doing what it is that you're supposed to be doing, enjoying the riches of Abraham. See, you don't have to be rich But if you know somebody rich and you're kin to somebody rich and you're kin to somebody who got a connection, and kin to somebody, see, that's what the problem a lot of men is. Because they got to be man, but they can't understand that you can get blessed and get behind the man.
Amen.
Come on, preacher.
You ain't getting a lot of amen on that.
Yes.
You get no base on that.
Yes.
We all want to be the man. We want to be the man. We want to be the man. And God said, if I don't choose you to be the man, you won't be the man until you humble yourself.
Amen.
When you humble yourself, maybe I'll make you a great nation. But until then, you worship an Ishmael. Watch this here. Abraham rose up early in the morning, took a bread, bottle of water, gave it to Hagar, put it on his shoulder, and the child had sent her
away.
She wandered in the wilderness. Now this wilderness is not nothing new to her. She did it before when it ended in Sarah, ran it off the first time. God told her to go back.
That's right.
Sometimes God wants you to stay in a place, man, where it's rough sometimes, because God has a lesson for you to learn.
That's right.
See, we always on the run. Every time someone don't go our way, we run.
We run.
I'm going to this church. Yeah, I don't like what he said. Put it in. Wait for the day I'm saying this. I'm going. See, but God said, I want you to stay in the lesson. Go back to the lesson.
Amen.
I want you to stay in the lesson because it's something that I need you to learn.
Yes, sir.
See, if you keep running all your life, you'll never get the lesson that God wants you to get.
Amen.
Go get somewhere and get planted where the word is going out.
Yes.
Guess what? It ain't about it. Watch it. Look at the Bible. It says in verse number 15, and the water was spent in the bottle. Mm-hmm. In other words, she ran out. Mm. She's thirsty. Mm. She's thirsty. She's thirsty.
Yes.
Mm. When you're in the hot water, I get thirsty. She's in the desert and the hot sun and and now she's feeling some type of weight. Think about it. These biblical figures, look here, they ain't human just like us.
That's right.
She's feeling some type of way. I got kicked out. Here it is, man. Ishmael was in the house. I was in the house. And now you didn't kick me out. And what it is that you asked me to do, and your wife told me to get in this priest with you, and now, man, you're going to kick me out?
Come on. Mm. Lord, have mercy.
And now my child is hurt?
Mm.
Now she's feeling some type of way.
That's right.
And see, watch this here. It's when we get to this stage right here. That's when it is we make the bad decisions.
Amen.
That's right.
Amen.
So the Bible said, and she was thirsty, she ran out of water. And the Bible said, she cast the child under one of the shrubs. Mm-hmm. Because one of the first things that we do when we're thirsty, we can't get what it is that we need, we start hiding. See, some of us are hiding. Even right now, we're hiding psychologically sometimes. We're hiding. See, because it's easier to hide than to admit that I'm thirsty. And the water was spent in the bottle, and she cast the child up under one of the shrubs, and she went and sat down over against him a good way off. And there was a bow shot, for she said, let me not see the death of my child.
Mm-hmm.
She's already just chalked it up.
Mm-hmm.
Get in a bad situation, I get thirsty, it's looking bad, I just expect to die.
That's right.
See, some of us have already given up.
Mm.
We've died to our dreams. We've died to our vision. We've died to what God has promised us. We've died to all of that. And all we do is just wait around. Another birthday come, just expecting to die. But Jesus said, I came to give you life.
Yes.
And life more
abundantly. Yes, Lord.
Why would I settle for death when God came to give me life?
Yes.
He came to give you life.
Yes.
He came to give you life. He came to give you life.
Yes.
here's where you speak right here.
Yeah.
Why would I settle for death in my marriage? Why would I settle? My wife's over here and I'm over here. And why would I settle for that? When did God tell me to settle for that? Why would I settle for death in the house? Sleeping next to somebody I can't even stand. Waiting for death. Waiting for death so I can get the insurance policy. What a life to live. But you can be, watch this here. When it is that you get thirsty, we can get in these kind of positions. These are real life positions.
That's right.
Watch this here. How you keep reading? The Bible says what?
And she went off and sat her down over against him a good way off.
Yes.
As it was a bow shot. For she said, let him not see the death of the child.
Yeah.
And she sat up against him and lifted up her voice.
Lift up her voice.
And wept.
And she's crying. Feel her pain, her failure, her rejection, her disappointment, her abandonment. She feels like everything, everybody has forsaken her. She gave her life to Abraham.
Yes, yes.
What do you do when it is that you give in your life and you give in your best to somebody and they totally forsake you and throw you out with a bottle of water?
Yes, come on.
What do you do? What do you do? How do you operate? How do you operate when it is that you cook and clean and give and wash the drawers and forsook your own self and didn't even get your hat done and put clear polish on your toes and didn't get your get to, so you can help him and then you find him with somebody else? So watch the Bible. It closes like this. I don't know where you want me. Watch this here. The Bible, it says, what alien be a God? Fear not. Watch this here. Why are we as Christians? I'm not saying we don't have to be cautious and concerned, but why are we going around scared when we serve them?
Amen.
Yes.
Why are we running around acting like we have no hope when we have all the hope that we have God?
Yes.
We have the Father.
Yes.
The Father can fix anything.
Yes.
The Father can heal anything.
Yes.
The Father can fix your grief.
Yes.
The Father can fix your credit. Yes. They keep on borrowing money from you. They about to send you away from yourself. The Father can fix it.
Yes.
Half of us are going crazy about somebody else's problem.
Yes. Come on.
They not even our problem. They got our own problem.
Yes.
We losing our mind on other people's problems. Sometimes we got to let people be. Let him go.
Yes, yes, yes.
If you want to stay stuck on stupid love, stay. A man want to be angry, let him be angry.
Yes, yes, yes.
Quit chasing people who don't want to drink.
That's right.
I don't chase people. If they don't want to be around me, then go on.
Amen.
I'm still going on the same with Jesus.
Yes.
The Bible says, yes. He says, read it one more time, John Titus. It says, but God is in the back. Fear not. Go ahead. For God.
For God hath heard the voice of the lad.
Yes.
He is.
Where he is. And then he says, what?
Arise.
Honey, God, I need you to get up. Watch this here. Not just physically. I need you to get up in your mind. God is telling you this morning, I need you to get up in your mind. Quit crying about that situation. Quit crying about that person who won't do you right. Quit crying about that family who keeps getting on your nerves. Why do you say, I need you to arise?
Yes.
Get up.
Come on.
I need you to get up. You've been down too long.
Come on.
You've been down too long.
Yes.
You've been down. Your marriage has been down too long.
Yes.
Your health has been down too long. I need you to get up. You've been crying too much. Let this be your last fear about that situation.
Come on.
Yes.
God said, arise.
Yes.
You've been crying too long.
Yes.
You've been crying too long.
Woo.
You've been reporting too long.
Yes.
Want to get in the church, man, and help out sometimes. Arise. Come on up to another level.
Come on,
come on up.
Come on.
Are you tired of staying on the same level? You're tired of broke living check to check? Arise.
Yes.
Arise!
Yes.
When it is that we arise, read it, Titus. It says, arise, and I want you to what?
Lift up the
lad. Lift up the lad. Watch this here. You can't lift your kids up until
you get up. That's right.
I can't lift nobody up until I get up in my own time.
That's right.
Yes.
That's right. Lift the lad up and read it, Titus.
And hold him in thy hand.
And hold him in thy hand. In other words, now I need you to be stable with him. You're a single mom. Nobody helped you. Nobody was looking out for you. The man left you with that child. But God said, I have to lift my hand.
Come on. Praise God.
I helped you.
Yes.
I'm the one who held you in my hand.
Yes.
I'm the one who gave you stability. I'm the one who didn't get that car off in your credit shop. I'm the one. But I need you to rise.
Yes.
And I need you to lift the ladder up.
Yes.
Because, Mama, if you don't get up, the kids can't get up.
Yes.
They see you with low self-esteem. They have no
self-esteem.
Right. Yes.
They see you chasing after the man all the time and he don't want you. That's what they're going to do to.
Right.
They see you, young man. They see the older man always being silly. Yeah, that's what the young man going to be.
Yes.
He says, arise.
Yes.
And then he said, go ahead, Titus. It says what?
Lift up the
lift up the leg, and I'm holding in my hand, and what?
A great nation.
He said, I'm going to make him
a great nation.
Watch him. Here's your shout moves right here.
Come on.
I got a great future for your children. Even though the daddy didn't do right, I still got a great nation. I'm still gonna make it great.
Yes.
Even though the person didn't do you right, I'm still in control.
Yes.
So he says, now, he said 19, he says, and God opened her eyes. Watch this here. Oh, but this, tell me, Richard, listen to me. He says, the realm was there all this time.
Lord, have mercy.
But what I did, when you did what I told you to do, I made it to where now, Coleman, that you can see your healing yourself.
Yes.
Yes, Lord.
I opened up
your eyes. Yes.
You better thank God for opening your eyes.
Yes. Thank you, Lord.
Thank God for somebody. Watch this here. When God shows you somebody that ain't right in your life, and he saves you 15 years with him, when he opened up your
eyes.
When he showed you a church that wasn't going nowhere, all he doing is partying, he opened up your eyes.
Yes.
So now you can get a word, but watch this here. She didn't get it by singing. She got it by a word from
the Lord.
I can't elevate just by singing.
Yes.
I can't praise. Praise is necessary. Praise is what I gotta do. But if I wanna go to the next level and pray, I gotta get the word.
Yes. Yes.
Yes.
Oh,
yes.
I gotta get the word.
Yes.
For me to be right around the well where water was.
Amen.
But God won't let me see it because I didn't get it.
Oh.
You may be next to the well for your life. Right now, you might be walking on the top of the well.
Yes.
But God won't let you see it because you won't get in
the word.
She saw the solution, the well of water.
Mm.
And she went, that's what she did, you know, like it. She filled the bottle.
You can't do it that
way. You can't do this thing that way. When God shows you water, you gotta go on
the way.
You're going to take care of your health. You got to go all in.
Yes.
If you're going to be a mama, you got to go all in.
Yes.
If you're going to be a good wife, you got to go all in.
Yes. Amen.
Time out when you have cups of water.
Come on.
Bring me a full cup. Lord, fill my cup. I want it overflow.
Yes.
Because God is the God of all.
Amen.
And if it's not a local soul, it's not a God.
Amen.
It's not gospel. Close it like this. Feel the bottom of the water.
Yeah.
And she didn't just take it just for herself.
Mm-hmm.
When it is that God blesses you, you give.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
The reason why some of us don't get it is because we get it and it stops with you. But when I learn, when God gives me something, then he, she, what? The Bible says she gave the leg.
Yes.
See, when God gives you something, you got to give it.
Yes.
Oh, have mercy.
too much is required from as much is given.
Uh-huh.
God gives you, God requires it.
Yes.
You know the reason why sometimes we in financial situations that we are? It's because we keep making $1,000 and $1,500 and $700 and $800 and you give them $5 and you give them $10. You ain't even giving, you're not giving, you're tipping. You're tipping. God gave you, but then you want to tip him. And God can take the job anytime he gets it.
That's right.
God can stop that shit. He can shut down the government for 2 months, and then what would you do with your little IQ Social Security check in? What do you do? Because it happened before. God was the one. I said, they can shut down the government. If they can't shut down the government, they can shut down checks too.
That's right.
So what do you do then with your bad self? I'm telling you, man, all we got is God.
Amen. That's
all
right.
All we got is God. 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 The dog ain't nothing. All we got is God. He made you cute because you got the little job. All you got is God. So if you go back to that old party and stuff, God gonna say, man, I'm gonna get you on the job. 3 weeks and then I'm gonna fire you again. Give us a job that we right back ready to party again. But that's what he's trying to call you away from in the first place. Mm. He's trying to call you the purpose, not the party.
That's right.
When his mama was down and out and she didn't have no more hope, God heard the cry of the baby because God said, I'm committed to these children because if one day fought for the dead of their home, and if one day fought, I'm going to make something great out of it.
Amen.
You can hear that. If you want a relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ,
yes, Lord.
How can you not serve the God like this?
Yes, God.
Even when the lady didn't have no more faith, he still did it on behalf of the child.
Yes.
But he did it more, not just for the child.
Yes.
He did it because of his covenant promise to Abraham.
Yes.
That was Abraham's boy, and he was going to not, God cannot lie, he's not going to go back on his covenant.
Amen.
That's shouting news to me, and it should be shouting news to you.
Yes.
Because if you're in covenant with God,
yes,
God says all you got to do is hang in there with me.
Come on,
all
yes.
you got to do is keep on praying. All you got to do is keep on studying. All you got to do is keep on talking about it. All you got to do is keep on being faithful. All you got to do is keep on minding your own business. Get off the telephone and keep on working and watch God work.
Amen.
You come to the Lord by faith, repentance, confession, and baptism.
Amen.
You hear today? And you want to renew your vows with the Lord.
Mm.
You just want to renew. You want to make sure. You want to make your election and calling sure. You want to make sure that you're all right with the Lord.
Yes.
Because you never know.
Mm-hmm.
Death could be on the other side of that door.
Yes.
It's not promised. People are coming down with this stuff every day.
Mm-hmm.
The question is, why should God keep you?
Mm-hmm.
Remember, we studied in Bible class today.
Mm-hmm.
He's going to wipe out 1/4 of the earth.
Yes.
Didn't we study that today in Bible class?
Yes.
He's going to wipe out 1/4 of the earth. Do you want to be in that number? Or do you want to be the number of the remnant that he said, I'm going to save them.
Yeah.
And I'm going to hide them.
Yeah.
Because they belong to me. They hung in there. They hung in there. Even when they didn't want to come to church. Even when they didn't have the strength to come to Bible study, they hung in there.
Yes.
And those are the people that I'm going to save.
Yes.
Because watch this here. Jesus hung in there for you.
Yes, he did.
So you got to hang in there for him. Be here today. Let us be standing on our feet. And the song of invitation is sung.